Well, hello everybody, it's HeapCVA. Welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for coming by. Welcome to Notruf 112 or emergency call 112. We're still in beta. They've added some things here recently and I want to go over them and kind of show you what's going on and see if you can see any difference in the game side. But let's talk real quick about something that they did that will be of great interest to those of you that really like to make changes in the game, might want to change the name of the vehicles, change their color, that kind of thing. If we, as we're in the start screen, is if we click settings, notice that there's now a link for customize. And so if I click on that, it opens up the this vehicle first, but in the upper right-hand corner, you can pick exactly what vehicle you want to fool around with. And so I'm still looking for some instructions, if you know what I mean. I do kind of like that you can see what a vehicle looks like under different lighting considerations. My thought on this is that, as you can see, the game installed certain files within the game itself that have graphic skins for all the units. And much like I showed everybody, if you saw my videos for 911 first responder / emergency 4, those very cluttered graphics that people can change the color of, etc., are very similar in this particular game. And so where this is very standard paint scheme for German fire service, you may want to make changes. I noticed, like, I can't think of the word. Well, I did think of it as Berlin. And I've seen some other images of some German fire apparatus that's not quite the fire engine red. That's the term that I use. It's probably not correct. That is very bright or reflective. It's tough to describe exactly what I see in those images. But definitely Berlin, their rigs stand out for sure. So anyway, these are PDF, not PDF. They're Adobe Photoshop PSDs. And you can open them in Photoshop, make changes. I'd make a copy of the original and save it somewhere because I think you can have one working image in the game. So I will spend some time working on that over time. In this particular, game, it's not as big a deal to me because these fire apparatus aren't leaving the country of Germany anytime soon. They're not going to move to another city. They're not going to change locations. And so the city that these units represent, I'm looking, NEF should be the doctor. Here's the TLF unit. So however that's pronounced, Mülheim, Melheim, and der Ruhr, good mash flat pronunciation of German. I apologize. But because this fire department for this game, it centers around one city, much like Emerge NYC does. I don't think that I'm going to make many changes, other to be a wise guy, maybe, any more than I would change anything in the New York mods or Emerge NYC game when it becomes one. Other than it would be nice if you could put the stickers like on the windshield and stuff like that. That's, you know, I think some of them already exist in the tech demo. So this is this part of it. And in addition to this, they've also created a Steam work for this game and it's been activated. So your artwork can be shown and utilized through Steam, and you can share that with others. Kind of a cool deal. Not exactly my cup of tea for this particular game, but it's a neat little addition that I thought you guys needed to see a little bit of. I'm keeping it very short and sweet because I haven't fooled around with it much myself. I'm just impressed that they put that in there. So let's go back to the game and we'll see what's been happening with the game itself and some updates that came in the beta branch. So give me just a second to switch over to the other view. Well, all right, I'm back. So let's look at patch notes real quick while we're letting Notruf 112 load. They've been really working hard on some bug fixes. The starting position CV, whatever that means. The aerial ladder basket didn't always connect to the ground, which would be a really bad thing. And wrong placement of the position marker, which is the yellow circle. That fixed rotating AI traffic. Not something I think I've seen. I'm glad they fixed it nonetheless. And invalid path calculation created paths leading through geometry. Sounds to me like they sent some paths right through buildings. That would be a little hard to do when you're on the fire apparatus. At least to me anyway. Hose reels couldn't be moved further after leaving the in-game menu. Not really sure what that means, but we got a fire alarm to go to. So let's do that while we're changed characters while I was at it. Fire alarms may or may not be anything. Anyway, they added missing mission texts. I'm thinking I've seen that, but I can't tell you how often or when the last time I saw it. Changed task list display. Hopefully I got that right the second time. New graphical terrain settings, which I'm kind of curious what that exactly means. But something got moved or shifted or kind of prettied up that has to do with what we see on the monitor. Adjusted range of vision. I'm hoping that means that we would see further away, but I'm not really seeing that. And I have this on relatively high settings, so. Optimized navigation area during missions. I just wish it would teach him not to run into the cars. Other than that, I don't have an issue. We are in a new location. I will say that for this fire alarm, which is good. It's always nice to have something new every once in a while. It's another store like the other one, but I don't know which side we're actually going to. You can hear the alarm. Something else on the list is added UI scaling to game settings. Still configurable in-game with left control plus page up. page down and home if you had to do that. Not really sure what we're going to do, nor do I know where we're going to do it. I'm watching the head kahuna do a lap, which is fine. I'm the attack section guy, so it looks like we're both going to go in, which is nice. So my number two guy is going to follow me. It's easier to go in the front door than it is the back if we can. So he's looking at the alarm panel right there. Actually, he's got his head down like he's asleep. Maybe he is asleep. I'm not going to touch him because he outranks me. Let's go in the supermarket. Hopefully my guy's following me. There he comes. So that one looks like it's doing okay. That one is okay. I can see it through the wall. So we gotta get in the right position. Come on, give it to me. All right, took care of it. I wonder if we can get out this way. Nope, gotta go all the way around. But it was nice to actually be followed by another firefighter, which I'm not thinking that's ever really happened before. So that would be positive. So we'll get out here. You know, it's funny how we run in, but we don't run back. Where did my guy go? I hope he gets back on the fire truck with us. I wonder if he got to go out the roll-up door while I had to go around. I'm going to look through the window and see if I can see him. There he is, right there. I had knock on the window, but I don't think that's going to happen. You know what I'm going to have to do, don't you? I'm going to have to change to F3 and get him to come out, or we're never going to get out of this incident. Now, at least he jogs. I guess because I'm carrying the Halligan tool, I've got to walk because it's a dangerous device. Notice that he went back to the engine, so that's good. And this guy's waiting for us all to get in. Hopefully he gets... There he goes. All right. Well, we're going to go back to the station, which is a time for me to cut away. But first, let's talk about the last two things on this list. Added automatic game pause when changing tasks as choice to game settings. And added customizer to swap vehicle textures, which we talked about. So some of it sounds almost like what I said in the last video, and I originally thought it was the same list, but it's not. I really like that they're working on this, and I know what you're thinking right now. Why aren't you doing emergency NYC, merge NYC? And I don't have a good excuse for you other than I think I said it in one other video, is that my point of view with the multiplayer, especially being all you're doing is driving, which is what we're doing every day right this minute, wasn't necessarily high up on my interest list. It's not a slam at anybody else. In addition, it's outside of the game. It's actually on a server, and you have to register and all of that stuff. And I just had not gotten there with that. I will likely do it eventually, but you know, that I have other videos that have, you know, not equal footing, but close to equal footing, and deserve their time on the channel as well. That's the only explanation I can give you. Every time I I play that tech demo and I have it open every day, at least for a little bit, whether I'm screaming around or driving, or I've read something on the forums about somebody having a problem and I want to replicate it to see if I'm seeing the same thing. And I'll be honest with you, I've seen some complaints about, well, this fire truck is crazy, the aerial ladder is messed up and not working correctly. I have not experienced that at all. Now, I've had some horn and siren problems early on. Haven't lately, since the last couple of updates. I can see that there are some actual changes in the game, minor, but still there, that didn't get published per se. They're still talking about just the multiplayer debut. Check out the street lights. Count how many hydrants you see. Things are happening. But I want to give them the chance to post so that, and they still haven't fixed this step. Maybe it's just me. Maybe this is the game I get to have problems with. What do you think? You know, and I know at least one person on my channel has said I should do that. I would assume that that's the news they're talking about, because really that's the only news there has been for Emerge NYC is about multiplayer. I mean, if you think about it, they brought in somebody from outside their small group who does nothing but that. And it's already had a few hiccups and issues that cause delays. So I can understand why they really, really wanted to get something out there that people could put their hands on any way possible just to see. Now, that said, have I seen a lot of jumping up and down, high fives, etc., 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 over what they did? I would have to say no. And that's too bad, because it's pretty obvious that some people are absolutely not going to give Flip Switch any credit. Some even think that this is a scam and that at the end of the day, we're not going to get anything. Well, they've been very upfront that, you know, especially because I paid the $50, that was an investment, and that they would do their best to release a game. With a date certain, no. But nonetheless, I just don't see Rafael Hernandez and his group just leaving everybody in the dust and taking their money and running. I mean, the guy, I believe, and somebody will have to correct me on this if I'm wrong, I believe he is either employed with or very connected, at least in the ability to know enough people to go on ride-alongs and stuff with FDNY. I don't think any of them want a black eye from somebody doing something where they're basically stealing money from other people. I just don't see that happening. So, enough of that for right now. I am spending some quality time reviewing and trying to learn the way FDNY, because it's really the only thing that's kind of available. Their radio technology, their communications, their 10 codes, how they say stuff, why they say K at the end of their transmissions, all those things, I mean, compared to where I am on the West Coast, is greatly different. It's not better or worse. Well, I think there's some of it that's probably more organized because it is the biggest fire department in the United States. But I would never say that the system that I have worked under in a couple of places on this side of the United States is better. That's not what I do. I don't mind sitting down with some FDNY people and having a friendly discussion over differences. That we do, and we have a good time at it. But at the end of the day, we shake hands, pat each other on the back, and wish each other the best of luck, and be safe, and all that good stuff. And so I'm trying to do that because I want to do some more of those incidents, and I want to get some of the lingo correct so I don't sound like such a buffoon on a given incident. So I've got two incidents in my head that I'm going to probably do either tomorrow or the next day and get that up while we're waiting for what was supposed to be an update this Sunday. I didn't think it was going to happen, to be honest with you. They're spending too much time on the multiplayer, so I wasn't going to freak out over it. So, all right, I talked through going back to the station, doing a lot of stuff. We're going to do this truck fire, and then I will break when we return back to the station. Let's see who gets the assignment for this. Sometimes I get the hose line, sometimes the other guy does. Okay. I was wondering if anybody was carrying any equipment. I wasn't really seeing anything going on. Maybe I should stand over here. It's like one guy's doing all the work. I still don't see any hose lines connected. Now the supply line is going from the water tender to there. There's a hose line. And I don't know how you would script these AI people to do anything any differently. I honestly don't have an answer for that. So I think, okay, when he drops that, then somebody's going to get assigned to get the, there he is right there. Foam nozzle, as per usual. So let's go. I haven't done this for a while. And of course, I had this, was playing it, I don't know, 3-4 days ago. And of course, first call out of the gate. Well, no, nobody was looking. A structure fire. Of course. That is just my luck, you know? And I told you that before one time, I think, is that I only have fires when I'm not recording. So, I got that put away. That should just about wind it up. For this call, the only thing we need now is some tow trucks. I can't see the police department, they're way too far away. So let me cut away while we drive back to the fire station, and I will see you when the alarm goes off again. So hopefully it won't take too long. Well, hey everybody, it's HeapCVA. Look at the call we're going to. Building fire, keep your fingers crossed. Believe it or not, I didn't skip any calls to get this. So keep your fingers crossed that we actually have an incident here. Sometimes it comes across in a couple of different wordings, but we should actually finally be going to an incident that's bigger than a trash can or a skip, as they call it. So we know the chief officer is responding. He should be coming out of the driveway here shortly. There he goes. Wham! He hit a car, which vaporized it. And see, he's facing the wrong way. Uh-oh. That is something that hasn't been fixed yet. I have no idea how they're going to fix that. You know, it seems like it gets worse instead of better sometimes. A lot of sharp turns, I think, have a lot to do with that. So I can see the circle. So my question is going to be, where exactly are we going to be? We're going to be down this street. I don't see any smoke. That was a big yellow circle. So don't know where it might be. Hopefully the chief officer shows up. There he is. I guess that means he parks in the back. I guess as long as he shows up, we get credit. He doesn't turn off his siren very often. They're all looking at the donut shop. It's actually just a bakery, but they're looking here somewhere. Now everybody's getting their hose lines out, so something is going on. So we'll just have to wait and see. I still don't understand why the line has to come off of that rig instead of getting the closer one that was on the fire engine. I'm just curious of which building we're actually going in. They're staring right into that doorway there. Or maybe it's that door they're staring at. Depends on who gets the assignment. So it looks like the other guy's going to get the assignment. Never let an assignment get stolen. Come on, just connect it to it for crying out loud. So are we going in here? We're going in here. Well, that was a pretty good guess. I hope I'm right. So we're not on that story. There it is. Okay. Nothing visible from here, so we got to start checking doors. This is all clear here. I can hear it. It's going to be one of these two. I wish I could shut that door. It doesn't give you credit for that. So knock down this. Cool down the ceiling. Got us a pretty good working little fire going on here. I'm watching my temperature gauge. Closer. My temperature gauge is still doing pretty good. I'm gonna knock down this thing here. Something is blocking it. Can you notice that there's something going on with it? Here, pick off the stuff that's hanging on the walls. That's going out. I'm just going to get this to go out. The thing is still fairly low, so it's not that I'm worried about. It's just what's the right angle to put this fire out with. This one does not want to go out. There it goes, you can see it. All right. So no fire spread. There would have been the problem if it had gone that direction. That looks okay. He's calling me downstairs, but I just have this thing about wanting to see. Whoops. As I step off the stairway. Oh, it's about time we had us an incident. This loaded, and looky there, and nobody even notices we had a fire. So doesn't say get on the fire truck yet. Yep, there it is. All right, well, we did it. Thanks for keeping an eye on that for me. Well, as we go back to the fire station, I have to say thank you again for coming by the channel. If you have any comments, questions, want to say howdy, etc., please leave them in the comment section for this video. I like going, getting back to you and answering them, answering questions, etc., etc. I just want to get this out of the way, and I'll get back to Emerge NYC in the next day or day plus, depending on how many incidents I can put together that I don't sound like a complete fool running the incident. If you don't have any comments that you want to leave, if you could leave a thumbs up or a thumbs down, lets me know whether I did a good job on the video or if I did a terrible job on the video with a thumbs down. At the end of the day, hopefully you had a great day or a great evening wherever you are on the planet. Hopefully everything went the way you wanted it to or is still going the way you want it to right now. You know, and I know that we'll bump into each other in the next video I put up. And with that being said, thanks so much for coming by. You guys take care and have a great day.